All right, guys, the next step that I'm going to do is install the servos. And before I do that, we with the kit, you get these great little carbon fiber servo arms. And the way that these go on is, I'll zoom in, the carbon fiber arms, and you take the circle horns that come with your servo. I'm going to be using the PowerHD DS090Ms, and they come with these little circle servos. There's also some star-shaped ones, and I think a little bigger circle one. But anyway, I'm going to go with this guy here, and the carbon fiber arm is simply going to sit right in the middle.
So I'm going to use a 16th inch
bit and drill through both of these, mainly the servo horn. And then I'm going to put a 256 bolt through and then put a nut with Loctite on the back. So I'm going to go ahead and do all the servo arms at once. So you've got four servo arms, two for the elevator, two for the ailerons, and then you have one rudder carbon fiber horn that came with the kit as well. So I'm going to do all five of those servos all at once, and then once I've completed that step, I'll start installing them on the surfaces. Alright guys, we're ready to go ahead and install the servos now that we've got all the servo arms installed on the servo horns. The next step, installing the servos is pretty straightforward in the surfaces such as the rudder and elevators. On the ailerons, it's a little trickier because we've got the hidden servo trays. Now that's how I'm going to end up mounting mine, though there is another option here. You can cut out the opening and just install it the standard way. But I'm going to show you guys how to do the hidden servo instead.
Okay, you can see on the back of
the hatch for the servo, there's an opening here that we'll cut out using our X-Acto knife. And then once we've done that, there's also four holes in the back as well that you'll need to just cut through just so you can put your bolts. And we've got two, well actually we have four, we'll use two on each servo, of these little, basically our servo mounting angles. So this is going to mount to this tray here, just like that, one on each side. And then the servo, which I don't have the proper servo here, but the servo is going to sit right on there and be bolted in. So let me go ahead and install this, and I'll show you. This is using our 3mm bolts that are included with the kit. They'll be threaded right through here, through the back, and a washer, and a bolt, just like that. And then they will go through and be threaded in to the aluminum L. And be sure and use thread lock on this connection here. Okay guys, you can see that I've mounted the servo tray to the servo arms, the aluminum arms that are going to hold the servo. Again, using washers on the back side, or on the front side, however you want to look at it. And then thread lock going into the aluminum. The next step is going to be to take your servo and to mount it onto the aluminum L's, just like that, using a bolt provided with the kit that will go through the arm and then be tightened down with a nut on the underside, again using thread lock. And then the only other thing is you're going to have to take out the metal sleeves on your servo for these bolts to fit through, unless you want to replace them with a thinner bolt, but I'd just probably take that metal out. So tighten all those down, again using thread lock on the nuts, and then once that's done, we can go ahead and mount the servo tray into the wing. Okay guys, and once you have your servo mounted into the tray, just drop it into the bay and then tighten it down with your four wood screws provided in the kit, and you have a nice clean installation. One quick note on the servo tray. When I mounted my servo originally, it was a little bit tight between the aluminum rails here. And so what I did is I took a drill and just kind of lengthened these holes a little bit just so that there's a little bit more play and I could expand that opening just a hair. And that kept it from being as tight and bowing this wood out a little bit. So if you find that your servos are doing the same thing, servos, you know, depending on the servo, are a little bit different size here and there. So that would be probably the easiest way to kind of work around that. Okay guys, now we're going to go ahead and mount the elevator servo. And this is very straightforward. There's an opening just in front of where the elevator mounts, about 2 or 3 inches. And you'll simply cut the film away with a sharp X-Acto blade. Now before you do this, you should go ahead and hit the plane again with your iron, just tack it down, especially near the spots that you're going to cut. Because once you cut it and then heat it, if it does shrink a little bit more, it's going to pull away from the hole and possibly, you know, show more of the wood. Now, it's not a huge deal. It's not going to... I haven't had that happen to where it's been aesthetically really bad, but you might as well go ahead and do so. So once you get that opening cut out, you'll put your servo in, mount it using your four servo screws, and that's done. So after you have this opening cut out, then you're going to take your servo and place it in there. And then what you want to do is, using a drill, you can just kind of, a little hand drill like this, you can mark each hole just lightly so that after you get your drill marks made, you can take the servo out and then finish drilling these all the way through. And after you've done that, you can go ahead and put the servo back in and then screw it in place with your servo screws. You can drop a little drop of thin CA into each of those holes to kind of harden the wood a little bit. And repeat on the opposite side. Then do the same procedure on the rudder, pre-drilling, put a drop of CA, and then finish screwing it in. And then all the servos will be installed. And one quick note also, when you mount your servo into the elevator back here, make sure that the servo arm is towards the rear of the plane and not in this position because the push rods are set up for this distance. And a quick side note, you can see that when you run your elevator servo wires through, we've gone ahead and installed within the framing some ports that you can run your wires through to keep them clean and out of the way of the rudder cables. Now that we've got all our servos installed, we're going to go ahead and start installing the linkages here, starting with the aileron. You'll use the shorter turnbuckle style control rod for the aileron rather than the longer ones that come in the kit. And just for your information, the way that these work is one thread, one end is threaded so that you turn clockwise to go into the ball link, and the other end you'll turn counterclockwise. That way when you spin one direction, they're both going in, and then when you spin the other direction, they're both unscrewing. So you'll just have to kind of get it started and see which one is turning clockwise and which one's counterclockwise, and then obviously the opposite end will be the reverse of whichever you started. So I'll go ahead and screw both of these in, and then after we get there, I'll show you the rest of the connection. I've got my rod threaded into each ball link, one into the control horn and one into the servo arm. With my aileron laying flat and my servo in neutral position where I want it placed, I've made the rod threaded to about the proper distance so it fits in there. And then the beauty of these turnbuckle style rods are that once you set up your radio and you find, you know, if your aileron is up a little bit or it's off a little bit, all you have to do for minor adjustments anyway is to take the turnbuckle with a wrench or a tool like this. You can turn it clockwise or counterclockwise, depending on how you have this rod set up, to either lengthen it or shorten it. So that way you don't have to take the whole assembly back apart to make some minor changes. Also, make sure that you've tightened all your bolts and nuts here, and make sure that you've got the bolt head, the washer, tapered washer, the ball, tapered washer, and then nut. And you want these tapered washers to be the thinner side, or the smaller side, to be facing the ball so that it has pivot room. Same thing on this side, you'll have your tapered washers on the inside of the control horns, and tighten that up. Repeat the same steps on the opposite wing.